Have you ever imagined turning something as simple as a CD into a glue so strong it can fix almost anything? It looks ordinary, right? But once this shiny disc meets heat, it transforms into something incredible. The reaction you're about to see is powerful, unpredictable, and surprisingly useful. Stay till the end, because this experiment might just change the way you see plastic forever. I start by dropping an old CD into a pot of boiling water. At first, it just floats. But as the heat builds up, the shiny layer begins to loosen. Safety reminder: always be careful with heat and chemicals. Never melt plastic in a closed space, and always wear gloves and a mask. Safety first, creativity second. Fine. Now I add a spoon of baking soda, and the reaction kicks in fast. The water starts bubbling wildly. Foam bursts up and spills over the edge. That's when the magic happens. The outer film peels right off, leaving behind a clear plastic base that will turn into glue later. Have you ever seen such a reaction from something so ordinary? Once the disc cools, I take it out and cut it into small pieces. Each little chip will melt faster in the next step. It feels strange. Something that once played music will soon become glue. Can you guess what color it'll turn when we melt it? By the way, thinking, where are you watching from? We've got viewers from the United States, the United Kingdom, Canada, and Australia, and it's awesome to see how creativity connects us across the world. Drop your country below. Excited? Let's see which flag shows up the most. Now, all those tiny CD pieces go into a glass cup. Then I pour in some acetone, just enough to cover them. It starts dissolving right away, forming bubbles and a light haze. To make it react faster, I use a heat gun to warm the mixture. Then I cover it and let it sit for a few minutes. 15 minutes later, when I open it, look at that. The solution has thickened into a shiny blue-green gel. Sticky, smooth, and flexible. Would you ever imagine this came from a CD? To make it even stronger, I cut some styrofoam into tiny pieces and add them into the cup. Right away, the texture changes. It becomes heavier and thicker. As I stir, it turns into a dense, rubbery paste that stretches and sticks to everything. This is it, the ultimate homemade superglue. Now it's time to test it. Phew. Here's my old shoe. The sole is completely detached. I use sandpaper to clean the surface, then wipe it with a little acetone to help the glue bond tighter. Remember, never heat acetone directly over fire. It's extremely flammable. Always work in open air or near a window. Don't use kitchen tools for experiments. Safety first, creativity second. Next, I spread the melted CD glue evenly on the sole and press it back together. It grips instantly, no movement at all. After a few minutes, the bond becomes solid. Five hours later. So, what do you think? Could this homemade CD glue replace store-bought adhesives? It's cheap, fast, and stronger than most glues you'll find. If you enjoyed this experiment, hit like and subscribe, because the next one will be even more surprising.